हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ पंकज दुरोड़े। आई एम टॉकिंग यू अबाउट डेडलॉक्स इन ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। बाय लुकिंग एट द इमेज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू, यू माइट बी थिंकिंग दैट द डेडलॉक इज यू नो सिमिलर लाइक लॉकडाउन इन जनरल टर्म्स दैट वी आर नाउअडेज एक्सपीरियंसिंग। सो इज इट रियली सो और वॉट एग्जैक्टली इट इज इन ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स? That we will going to see with the help of this video. So let us start. In multi-programming system, a number of processes compete for limited number of resources. And if a resource is not available at that instance, the process enters into waiting state. The diagram which is drawn over here, this diagram it is basically for a resource allocation graph, in which we are observing that process 1 is holding one resource and process 2 is holding another resource, that is resource 2. Now resource 1 is assigned to process 1 and so forth, resource 2 is assigned to process 2. Now at the same time, what is happening over here? Process 1 has already holding a resource 1, requesting for resource 2, which is already held by process 2. And process 2, which is already holding a resource 2, is requesting for resource 1, which is already assigned to process 1. Right. So if this kind of situation arises, right, that is considered as a deadlock in operating systems. Now that is what is explained here. If the process is unable to change its waiting state indefinitely because the resource requested by it are held by another waiting process, then the system is said to be in the deadlock. So, with the help of this particular graph, probably the things might getting clear to us. Now we will take a few examples, and I'm sure with the help of those examples, the concept of deadlock will be really clear. So, for example, government office work. Now what happens with the government office work? If I have some work to do, at that particular time I visit to government office. Now in government offices what happens? I am supposed to go, let us say at table number 1. Now when I visit the table number 1, at that time what happens? The person informs me that you have to do this work with the person who is at table number 5, let us say for example. Then again what I do, I visit to table number 5 for doing that work, and again the table number 5 person says me that this work can be done with the help of table number 12 person. Again I go at the table number 12, and what happens there when I go, actually the person says me, this work you can do with the help of the person who is at table number 1. Now see, what is the use of, you know, roaming here and there? From where I have started, there I am ultimately coming. So this is a kind of an example I want to actually tell you, that this says that a deadlock is happening. Right. Another example we will take, for example, opening a bank account. Now while opening a bank account, let us say I am going to some bank. Now the bank person will say me, if you want to open the bank account, you need to have the Aadhaar card Xerox. So practically I don't have Aadhaar card, let us say. So what I will do, I will visit to Setu Suvidha Kendra, wherein I will ask the person that I want to, you know, generate my Aadhaar card. So the person is saying me at that time to generate your Aadhaar card, we will need your bank passbook, Xerox. So now I see what has happened. To do one work, I was dependent on another person, right? And that another person is again showing his dependency on my previous work. So this is, you know, a funny kind of scenario. And because of that, what is happening now, my one single work is not getting completed. Any single work is not getting completed. So generally what happens in operating system, right? There are basically four different conditions which are required to ensure that there is a deadlock in operating systems. So they are actually mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, and circular wait. So these conditions, how they are executing, right? That we'll going to see with the next video. But in operating system, it is ensured that the system is following a system model, and that system model is the first. Every process will request for a resource. If entertained, then the process will use that resource, and once the process have used that resource, process must release that resource after use, so that the another processes should not go into a deadlock. Thank you.